This is the story about the God who loves us in the Bible. We find truth and purpose to love God and love others. We're searching God's word for things to discover. Is alive.
Father God, I am yours. Every day I will say, Father God, I am yours. I am a child of God. Cheer me up when I am sad. Make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. Father God, I am yours. Every day I will say, Father God, I am yours. I am a child of God. Cheer me up when I am sad. Make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. You cheer me up when I am sad. You make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. I am a child of God. I am a child.
Good morning, boys and girls, and happy Sunday. We are so excited that you're joining us for Kids Church online, or perhaps even face-to-face here at St. Mark's Church. We are so excited to have you with us today. In today's lesson, we'll be hearing about a crazy vision. Do you know what a vision is? A vision is like you're dreaming, but you're not actually asleep. Are you ready to hear today's Bible story? Jump in with us.
Everybody's welcome. Cornelius was an officer in the Roman army. He lived in a place called Caesarea. He and his family respected God. They weren't Jewish, they were Gentiles. Cornelius had a vision. An angel told him, "God hears your prayers and knows that you help the poor. Send men to Joppa to bring Peter here." So Cornelius did. In Joppa the next day, Peter was on the roof praying. In a vision, a huge sheet came from heaven. It was filled with animals. A voice said, "Kill something, Peter. Eat." They were animals that Jews weren't allowed to eat. "I can't eat them," Peter replied. "If I say they're all right to eat," the voice replied, "then they're all right." That's when Cornelius' messengers arrived. So Peter and some others went with them to Caesarea. Cornelius' house was filled with his friends and family, eager to hear Peter speak. "God showed me, in a vision, that he accepts people from every nation. God sent Jesus to everyone. He is Lord of all. He healed the sick and freed the oppressed. He was crucified and then raised from the dead. Everyone who believes in him will be forgiven of their sins." The Holy Spirit came upon them, just like Pentecost. Peter baptized them.
today's Bible story, we heard about a crazy vision that Peter had. Peter was one of Jesus' early disciples, who was one of the key leaders in the church. Just like Paul, Peter would teach people all about Jesus. One day, God came to Peter in a vision. A vision is like you're dreaming, but you're not actually asleep. And in the vision, Peter saw a big sheep full of animals, and a voice told Peter to eat the animals. In the Jewish tradition, there were certain animals that were considered unclean, and the Jewish people couldn't eat the meat from those animals. But some of those unclean animals were in the vision. So Peter said, "No way, I'm not going to eat those animals." But God was teaching Peter a lesson, and it wasn't really about the animals, it was about people. God's people, the Jews, did not eat certain animals, but in Peter's vision, God told him it was okay to eat those animals. This meant that anyone could be part of God's family, even if they did not keep the same rules that the Jews did. And just like certain animals, Jews also thought non-Jews or Gentiles were unclean and unimportant people. They didn't think that they were worthy of God's love. But that wasn't God's heart at all. Jesus came to die for everyone, the Jews and the Gentiles. So Peter realized that the Gentiles deserved to hear about Jesus too. Peter told Cornelius and his friends that God's love is not just for the few Jewish people. God sent his gift of the Holy Spirit to everybody, the Jews and the Gentiles alike. So God's love and the forgiveness is available to everybody who believes in Jesus. God welcomes everyone. Jesus died so that all people can be forgiven from their sins. So let this story remind you that God welcomes everybody. Because he sent the Holy Spirit, you and I can be part of his family. Jesus loves every single person in the whole wide world, even the ones who are the most different from you and me.
Hey kids, can you think of somebody that's different from you? Maybe they wear weird hats or act really strange. Or maybe they just look different from you or speak a different language.
Do those differences make it hard to get to know someone?
Well, in today's story, we're going to talk about how Jesus loves everyone,
no matter how they look or act. Let's get into the story.
Peter had a crazy vision one day. One day, he was praying, and he saw a vision from God.
In Peter's vision, he saw a big white sheet come down from the sky, and on it were a bunch of animals.
Then a voice told him to cook and eat all the animals. Kind of weird, right?
So, what's going on here? The vision was about unclean food.
Back in those days, if you were Jewish like Peter, there were a lot of rules on what you were allowed to eat.
All the animals he saw on the sheet, he wasn't able to eat.
They called them unclean. So why would the voice tell him to eat them all?
Let's see what was really going on. The vision was really about unclean people.
See, back in those days, Jewish people like Peter stayed away from people that were different from them.
They didn't follow God, and they didn't follow the same rules. So they called them unclean, too.
And worst of all, they thought God didn't love them.
That's why God gave Peter this vision, to show him that God loves all people.
So if it's okay to eat that food, it's okay for him to love those people. Peter learned an important lesson that day.
God can make everyone clean. Get it? God loves everyone, and he can make everyone clean. Memory verse.
Do not call something unclean if God has made it clean. Ultimately, everyone is unclean because everyone sins.
And Jesus came and died for everyone so we can all be clean.
This is the lesson that Peter learned. It wasn't about being Jewish. It's about knowing Jesus.
So next time you see someone that's different from you, remember, God loves them just like he loves you.
And that means you should love them too.
yo, yo, yo.
Boys and girls, are you ready to colour in today's Bible story with us?
We've loved having you join us for Online Kids Church this morning. We hope you've enjoyed today's story about Peter's vision. May it always remind you that God welcomes everybody, and because He sent His Holy Spirit, you and I are part of His family. He loves every single person in the whole wide world, even the ones that are different from you and me. Don't forget to print, color in, and cut out this week's Bible character puppets. Perhaps you could use the puppets to share today's Bible story with your family. See you next week.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Let's praise the Lord.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Let's praise the Lord. Let's praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Let's praise.
What did Peter see in his vision? What did Peter tell Cornelius, his family, and his friends about God?